This is the OTB Television Network, a service of Capital District Off-Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses. 18 races to bring you as we bring the curtain down at Del Mar and Saratoga and raise the curtain September style at Churchill Downs. But we're going to kick it off going back to Labor Day. Four big races to bring you from Parks Racing. Up first will be the seventh running of the Turf Amazon Handicap. The 3-2 favorite, Silverette.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Turf Amazon. And Subtle from the inside breaks on top. Subtle sprints to the lead. Little River and Lorelei Song right there, second and third. On the outside, Silverette is close up in fourth. A length and a half to Too Clever by half fifth. After that, it's 2.5 to Miss Cruz in sixth. Sensible Lady is seventh. She is just better than five back at this point. After that, it's Mosaicist and Wellington's Appeal. They race past the three gates pole. And Silverette now joins Subtle up front. Subtle on the inside by a half length. Silverette right with her. She's second on the outside. It's 2.5 to Lorelei Song in third. Then it's a wide break of some five back to Sensible Lady. She's got a lot of running to do from fourth as the leaders turn for home. On the inside, it's Subtle. On the outside, it's Silverette. Those two are head-to-head past the gate pole. Silverette and Subtle going at it as they come to deep stretch. Silverette on the outside. Subtle on the inside. Silverette gains the advantage late and edges out. It's Silverette. Silverette's got it by just over a length. Subtle was second. Sensible Lady was up for third.
And Silverette from the outside post position coming off of the victory in the turf debut at Saratoga in the Caress Stakes. Now makes it 2-for-2, lifetime on the turf, both in stakes action as they win the lucrative $200,000 Turf Amazon by a little bit more than one length under Robbie Alvarado. Silverette returns $5 even going out for Dale Romans and owner Paul Pompa on a yielding turf course. You see the 57.73 final running time. Subtle finishes second and Sensible Lady finishes third in the Turf Amazon. Over to the dirt, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to run a mile and a half in the Greenwood Cup. The 5-2 favorite, El Defar.
Here at the gate. And they're off in the mile and a half Greenwood Cup. Sky Venture breaks on top. And Sky Venture goes on to get that early lead. Charlie Bull is quite content to release him as they make their way onto the far turn for the first time. Sun's out, guns out. Now moves up third on the outside. Chief Energy will sit a ground-saving fourth. El Doffer settling into stride back at the fifth position. It's about three and a half back to reserve pool play. And late running, Indigo Jones is quite content to sit at the back of the pass last of the seven as they hit the stretch for the first time. Sky Venture has been guided well off the rail here. Sky Venture is leading it by just about two lengths as Charlie Bull will stalk second on the outside. Chief Energy has a spot down inside. Sun's out, guns out on the outside. Those two are side by side for the third and fourth positions. The opening quarter mile over the sloppy track was 24-1. They ran the half in 49-4. El Doffer is fifth as they go onto the clubhouse turn. And El Doffer is about four lengths off of Sky Venture. And then it's farther back to pool play. Pool play has almost seven to make up. And India Jones yet to unleash his run from the back of the pack. Well, Sky Venture has led pretty much every step of the way. And with six furlongs to go, the long shot leader at 30-1 is on top by about two lengths. Sun's out, guns out. Now coming up in between horses to take second. Charlie Bull is third on the outside. Chief Energy has fallen back just a bit. Chief Energy has dropped almost four back with 5/8 to go. El Doffer trying to make an advance from the inside. Here comes Pool Play now. Pool Play beginning to advance from the back of the pack with a half mile to go. He's up within five lengths of the lead. And Indian Jones in with a chance at the back of the pack. He's moving well to the seventh position as they now head to the final turn. Sky Venture is still on top. Sun's out, guns out, begins to make his run on the outside. El Doffer is down at the rail. Pool Play is coming up between horses. And here comes Indian Jones with a strong run on the far outside. It's El Doffer. El Doffer got first run. And El Doffer comes to the corner pole, but Indian Jones takes aim on the outside. Indian Jones on the outside. El Doffer the inside. Pool play is third as they turn for home. Middle of the racetrack, it's Indian Jones. El Doffer digs in. Those two come down to the last furlong. Indian Jones, El Doffer, nothing to separate those two. Pool play is a driving third. El Doffer, Indian Jones, a stirring stretch run of the Greenwood Cup. Indian Jones on the outside. El Doffer on the inside. They're bobbing heads as they come to the finish. It's El Doffer. El Doffer wins it by a nose over Indian Jones. Pool play was third.
Ladies and gentlemen, El Doffer on a muddy sealed racetrack. 12 furlong scores by a nose under Ricardo Santana, returning $7 even for this offspring of AP Indy, himself a mile and a half on the dirt winner. Of course, that was the Grade 1 Belmont 21 years ago. But for El Doffer, you often hear at the Belmont Stakes the last time they'll be asked to run a mile and a half on dirt. Well, El Doffer didn't run in the Belmont Stakes, but did run in four consecutive editions of the Brooklyn, a first, a second, a third, and a fourth, and now adds the Greenwood Cup, the Grade 3 to the resume. Indian Jones finishes second. Pool play checks in third in the Greenwood. Back to the turf and sprinting at five furlongs. This is the Turf Monster Handicap, the 2-1 favorite, Ben's Cat.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Turf Monster Handicap. Ben's Cat is away well. AP Elvis on the outside comes rushing out of there. Tight end touchdown showing his speed on the inside. Tight end touchdown to take the lead. Varsity is now second. Wicked Tune on the outside third. Followed by Storm of the Century fourth. Chamberlain Bridge fifth. Consul moving through down inside sixth. Ben's Cat is in mid-pack. He is seventh between horses. After that comes a wide AP Elvis. And then it's farther back to Northern Hammer, and way back there is Strong Impact. They're midway on the turn. Tight end touchdown in front by just over a length. Wicked Tune on the outside second. Varsity coming with a run. Ben's Cat is getting in gear on the far outside. Storm of the Century down inside. He has a chance, but it's tight end touchdown. Furlong to the finish. Tight end touchdown by three. Storm of the Century closing in. Here comes Ben's Cat on the outside. Could he do it again? Storm of the Century is rallying to take the lead. Ben's Cat on the outside. Storm of the Century. Ben's Cat on the inside. Tight end touchdown. Storm of the Century at 25-1. Storm of the Century, an upset winner.
Storm of the Century, ladies and gentlemen. It was Stu Elliott, now 2-for-2 under Stuart Elliott. This time, though, Storm of the Century returns $59.40 to his backer. First time in stakes company, lights up the board, winning the Turf Monster. Tight end touchdown, finishes second. And Ben's Cap, who was 4-for-5 lifetime at Parks, had won this race the two previous editions, finishes third this year. And wrapping up the Labor Day action at Parks, three-year-olds going a mile to 70 on the dirt, the Smarty Jones, Edge of Reality, Snake Pit, the 5-2 entry favorite.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Smarty Jones Stakes. Good start for the ball. On the inside, it's Edge of Reality. From between horses, here comes English Matter. And on the outside, it's Between Here and Cool. Those three across the track into the first turn. Speak Logistics has a spot down inside fourth with Bellarmine fifth. Snake Pit is between horses sixth. Down inside, Micromanage much closer today. He's in behind horses, about 3.5 lengths behind. Uncaptured is in the clear, but four wide around the first turn. After that comes Norum Bega, who settled at about 6 lengths off the lead, and two more back to Battier. First quarter shows in 23-4. The three-year-olds are on the back stretch with 5/8 to go. Edge of Reality now leads the way by a length. English Matter, long shot sitting second by a length. Good trip for Speak Logistics, who's just in behind those two at the inside third. It's another length back to Between Here and Cool, is on the outside fourth. Snake Pit is fifth with a half mile to go. He's about 3.5 back. Another length back to Bellarmine. No advance yet from Uncaptured. Uncaptured was four wide around the first turn, but has now been taken down inside and begins to run on. Battier is beginning to pick off horses on the far outside. No response right now from Micromanage. No response right now from Micromanage. Coming to the quarter pole, Edge of Reality now bracing for an outside challenge from Speak Logistics. About 2.5 to Uncaptured, who now rallies within striking range third. Field comes off the turn. Stu Elliott goes to work on Edge of Reality. Speak Logistics now on the attack on the outside. Those two pass the A-pole. Edge of Reality still holding on. Speak Logistics, a late surge. Edge of Reality still in front. Speak Logistics trying to get to him late. Edge of Reality. Speak Logistics, it's Edge of Reality. Yes, sir. Edge of Reality wins it by a neck over Speak Logistics.
And the Anthony Dutro part of the entry scores the victory, exiting a fourth place finish in the Curling Stakes at Saratoga. They make every pole a winning one under Stu Elliott, returning $7.80. Speak Logistics, coming off of an allowance race, finishes second. And Uncaptured, the recent winner of the middle jewel of the Canadian Triple Crown, the Prince of Wales Stakes, finishes third as second choice in the wagering. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, we'll be having action from Presque Isle, Delaware, and Arlington Park.
Here in upstate New York, no one provides bettors with more wagering options than Capital OTB. Our network of branch and easy bet locations stretches from the mid-Hudson Valley all the way to the Canadian border and west to central New York. So whether you need to place a bet, fund your Capital Bets account, or watch the next big race, all the action is just around the corner. A full list of our branch and easy bet locations can be found online at CapitalOTB.com. Capital OTB, the better and most convenient choice for wagering in upstate New York.
No matter where in the world you are, the excitement of wagering on horse racing is just a click away. CapitalOTB.com offers live streaming, past performances, race replays, our virtual tote board, analysis and selections from professional handicappers, and a simple, safe, and secure wagering platform. And best of all, you get track prices. Going on now, it's Bet 50, Get 50. Simply open a Capital Bets account, bet $50, and get $50 cash back. CapitalOTB.com. Log on today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to Sunday evening at Presque Isle, the Presque Isle Mile, the 5-2 favorite, Hoagie.
They're off in the Presque Isle Mile. Slow start for What the Cat drug in, but good start for Mongolian Saturday. An Occasional View between horses. Ponzi Scheme has some early speed, and also Super Chunky. Around the turn they go. Mongolian Saturday is going to show the way. Occasional View down along the rail. Ponzi Scheme in between. Super Chunky's three wide in between horses. And Mazzano is next. To the far outside is Hoagie. Then up in between those horses is Hoof It. Right alongside is What the Cat drug in. A gap of four lengths. Back to Gourmet Dinner. And the trailer is Photo Shoot. Up the back stretch they go. Mongolian Saturday shows away with Willie Martinez after a quarter in 24-1. Has it by two lengths over Ponzi Scheme. Super Chunky to the outside. Occasional View to the inside. Then in between those two is Alpha Better. Amazano. Right in good spot there. Then on the inside, What the Cat drug in. Hoof It. Hoagie's moving well to the far outside. Mongolian Saturday still has it by a length and a half. Ponzi Scheme along in second. Super Chunky in a good spot. Alpha Better's now gotten geared up in there in between horses. And here comes Hoagie about three wide and Hoof It behind that one. At the top of the stretch is still Mongolian Saturday trying to hold them off. Occasional View still there. Super Chunky. Hoagie's now clear, as is Hoof It. To the far between horses, it's Occasional View that's getting the best of it. Here comes Super Chunky and Hoagie. Occasional View's your leader. Hoagie to the outside. Super Chunky, Mongolian Saturday. Hoagie on the far outside, and Hoagie gets up and wins it. It's a four-way photo for place. Super Chunky, Hoof It, Mongolian Saturday, or Occasional View.
And Joe Rocco Jr., ladies and gentlemen, who has certainly amped up the career over the last 5 or 6 months, right on our radar screen, goes from a successful Saratoga to a Sunday evening victory at Presque Isle under Hoagie, who had won the Troy Stakes at Saratoga. Now as the Presque Isle Mile, returns $7.80 for Wayne Catalano and the victory. Super Chunky finishes second. Hoof It finishes third in the Presque Isle Mile. Going to down to Delaware Park, ladies and gentlemen. Three-year-olds on the turf in the Kent Stakes. Are You Kidding Me? The 7-5 choice.
And they're off in the Kent. Are You Kidding Me? Toward the inside away well. As they're racing down the chute, hard enough on the far outside, Majestic Jess with the rail. The first two are well off the inside track of Majestic Jess as they come off the chute. Are You Kidding Me leads it by a length over Majestic Jess. Up on the outside, Hard Enough is taken in hand in third. Then a gap of two lengths further back. Gran Tito toward the inside. Right there, that's Fear the Kitten. Then a gap of two lengths further back. Michael With Us in the trailer. Into that first turn is Ready, Shake, Go. Opening quarter in 25-1. Very easy tempo being set by the leader. Are You Kidding Me leads it by a length and a quarter over Majestic Jess and Hard Enough. Two lengths further back, Gran Tito is perfectly positioned in fourth. Then a gap of two lengths further back to Michael With Us in fifth. Followed by up on the outside, Fear the Kitten. Trailer still Ready, Shake, Go as they make their way down the backstretch. Hanfen, 48-3. They picked it up just a bit that quarter. On the front end, Are You Kidding Me? By a length with Mirage showing the way. Right there, Hard Enough in second. It's about two and a half lengths to Majestic Jess. Up on the outside, Gran Tito. Michael With Us toward the inside. Three lengths further back to Fear the Kitten. And Ready, Shake, Go continues the trail. About nine lengths off that lead. They race into the turn with just over 3/8 to go. And Are You Kidding Me? Is going well on the front end. Leads it by a length and a half over Hard Enough. Majestic Jess with a rail run. Followed by Michael With Us picking up the tempo just a bit. Gran Tito on the outside. Fear the Kitten. Ready, Shake, Go lagging behind as they head for home with Are You Kidding Me to catch. Are You Kidding Me? Rajiv Mirage leads it by two. Majestic Jess, Hard Enough continue to chase in vain. Michael With Us trying to gain in third. Are You Kidding Me? The Canadian Import is in command with a 16th to go. Are You Kidding Me? Nope. Are You Kidding Me? Wins the Kent by about 4 or 5 lengths. Michael With Us on the outside, on the inside, Hard Enough tight for second and third. Ready, Shake, Go rally belatedly in fourth.
And with Rajiv Mirage in the saddle for the first time, Are You Kidding Me, who is 6-1 on the morning line, goes to the front and scores by a commanding 4-length victory in the Kent Stakes. Owned and bred, the owners are the breeders. Also, Roger Atfield, who has had a very, very, very sharp last 2 years, trains the winner. Are You Kidding Me returns $4.80. Michael With Us finishes second. Hard Enough finishes third. This was a new running style for Are You Kidding Me? Had never shown that type of early speed. Previously had been 0-6 in stakes action, including 4 of them on the turf, but now has the Grade 3 Kent victory on the docket. Going out to Chicago for a couple juvenile stakes races, and you'll see it twice on this week's show, where the 2-year-old fillies run faster than the 2-year-old colts. Up first, the Arlington Washington Futurity, High Roll, the 3-1 favorite.
And the gate. They're off in the Arlington Washington Futurity. Between horses, Solitary Ranger in the yellow, nearest the inside, Lot of Mischief vying for this early lead along with Solitary Ranger. And those two juveniles come toward the main track together. High Rolls now gained third from Joe Dini on the outside. CNO in the black cap comes up the inside in the leading quintet, a break of 2.5 to Why Are You Awesome. And the Eider spread, Captain's Affair, has dropped back to last. The quarter in 22 4/5 seconds. The pace is on. Lot of Mischief has locked horns early on with Solitary Ranger, who's a half length off of Lot of Mischief as they head to the half mile pole. Cisco Torres has High Roll just in that third spot from CNO, fourth and tucked in toward the rail. Why Are You Awesome travels together with Joe Dini and still four more to Captain's Affair, who gets his cue already by Mike Smith. Just under a half mile to go. 4 furlongs on the straightaway, 46 2/5 seconds. Still these two out in front. Solitary Ranger has forged to a short lead from Lot of Mischief, who comes back on terms. Around the far turn, High Roll is right there. Now this move from Why Are You Awesome, who's moved up here for Diego Sanchez and looms for Solitary Ranger. CNO has been steered to the far outside, also picking it up as they turn for home. Captain's Affair, Joe Dini was last into the stretch. 3/4, 1:11 4/5 seconds. Solitary Ranger past the eighth pole on a 2-length lead. Why Are You Awesome mugged in again, and Solitary Ranger kept on for Florent Giroux. The Futurity champion, Solitary Ranger, pulled away from Why Are You Awesome. It was a half dozen lengths back to CNO third, then further back Captain's Affair from High Roll, Joe Dini, and Lots of Mischief, who vied early, last to finish in a flat 1:38.
Solitary Ranger, ladies and gentlemen, draws off to win by better than a handful. There were four runners on the board between 3-1 and 4-1. This one was 7-2 going out for Wayne Catalano, who wins his third Arlington Washington Futurity in the last 5 years. Why Are You Awesome finishes second. CNO finishes third as the longest shot on the board, ladies and gentlemen, in a field of seven at 9-1. You see the final running time there, 138.17. Well, now it's time for the two-year-old fillies. Ungraded, a listed stakes race, the Arlington Washington Lassie, Maria Maria, 5-2.
All set. And they're off in the Arlington Washington Lassie. Here's Richie Sweetheart quickly coming to the fore. Sweet Southern Dame in the white cap on the far outside. Divergent View also prominent in the early stages, as is Istanford. And toward the inside, she's awfully good with a black cap. On to the main track. They're being led by Richie Sweetheart, who's out in front of Istanford, who gained second. Divergent View toward the inside. Here's Tamazula with the red sleeves for Kent DeSormo. She's awfully good, splits fillies. Sweet Southern Dame, sixth on the outside, and five from Richie Sweetheart, who takes them through a quarter in 22 3/5 seconds. Bellarada together with Maria Maria. When we come back to it, the inside, running toward the back half of the field is Gumdrop between Philly's Battlefield Angel. Look Who's Here is wide and 11th. They have a half mile to go. Four furlongs for Richie Sweetheart, 45 2/5 seconds on the straightaway. So Istanford in pursuit of Richie Sweetheart with Tamazula third and trying to draw in. So this is three furlongs out. Istanford having a go now at Richie Sweetheart. Looming is Tamazula. She's awfully good in fourth. On the outside, Sweet Southern Dame, fifth being asked to pick up. Maria Maria has the red cap. She's drawn to within four from the top. Right with her, Battlefield Angel. Bellarada being ridden with the whip. Gumdrop is wide. Then Divergent View. Look Who's Here is last. Into the stretch. 3/4, 1:10 4/5 seconds. Here comes Tamazula charging now. On the outside, she's awfully good. Nearest the inside is Istanford. Maria Maria, Gumdrop on the far outside with Battlefield Angel. Past the 16th. She's awfully good in front here. She's awfully good. Pulls away late. She's awfully good. Won it from Sweet Southern Dame. It was close for third between Maria Maria, Tamazula, Battlefield Angel, even Istanford. A bunch finish and back of She's Awfully Good.
She's Awfully Good, though. Eddie Castro aboard. They go 0.19 seconds faster than the boys. She's Awfully Good, a $12.20 victor. Sweet Southern Dame finishes second. And Maria Maria, the fourth start of the career and first time versus winners under Francisco Torres, finishes third as the 5-2 choice. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, September action at Churchill Downs.
Face it, some mobile websites are just too much. Too much clutter. Too much to navigate through. Next time, log on to CapitalOTV.com. There you'll find everything you need. Clear, concise, easy to navigate. Check your account, wager, watch replays, get results. All the information you want with none of the clutter. CapitalOTV.com mobile. Try it now.
Listen to what people are saying about the Clubhouse Racebook.
It's really nice. It's really modern, open, bright, and there's definitely a lot more machines where you can make your wagers. And I like the fact that it's open. Anywhere I look, I can see football if I want to, or any of the tracks. Then I can also see the people that I've seen for many years. You feel comfortable. The staff is great. It makes you feel comfortable. It's a nice place to spend an afternoon on the weekend.
Churchill Downs in September, ladies and gentlemen. Now time for the two-year-old fillies to run faster than the two-year-old boys. This is the Pocahontas Stakes, Stonetastic, the 8-5 choice.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Pocahontas. Milam is the one who gets the early lead. Towards her inside is Elena Strikes, also right up there, and untappable against the inside rail. Stonetastic takes a fierce hold, racing now in joint third as they make the first turn. Nevada Deputy is next with 7/8 a mile to go. Rosalind has got two behind in the early going. Red-headed Witch, and at the back of the pack is Harlan Special as they went through the quarter in 23-3. Inside the final 3/4 of a mile of the 45th running of the Poker Hunters, and it's John Velasquez and Elena Strikes out in front now by 3/4 of a length. Milam is racing in second, untappable to the inside in third. The grey Stonetastic to the outside is in fourth. 2.5 lengths away to Rosalind towards the inside. Towards the outside is Nevada Deputy, Harlan Special, and Red-Headed Witch at the back of the field, the half in 48-2. And they leave the back stretch in the Poker Hunters, and the leader is Elena Strikes. She's out in front now by only a head. Moving to the outside is Milam. These are now the first two. Stonetastic now begins to make her presence felt around the outside. Untappable is back in fourth as they make the turn with 1/4 mile to go. And it's now Milam who has got the lead over Stonetastic in second. Untappable is in third. Elena Strikes is beat now. She's back to fourth. Racing inside the final furlong and a half. Stonetastic Strikes goes for home. Milam towards the inside. Down the outside. Untappable continues to surge. Stonetastic needs the line. Untappable on the outside. Untappable to win the Poker Hunters. A second win in the Poker Hunters for both Steve Asmussen and Rosina Pravnik as Untappable breaks the heart of Stonetastic in the drive to the line to win the Poker Hunters.
Untappable. Rosina Pravnik aboard this year. She was aboard Sign last year for the $3.80 victory. Now she's aboard Untappable, the $13.60 victory, winning by a half a length for Steve Asmussen, who won this race back in 2004 in the second career start. A graded stakes winner for Untappable. Stonetastic, coming off with a debut win, finishes second. Rosalind finishes third in the Pocahontas, and you look at the 112.50 to the pace call, as it were, and 144.38. And now it's time for the boys going 1 mile and 1/16, the new distance, along with the new part on the calendar for the Iroquois, as it was for the Pocahontas. Ride on Curlin, the 2-1 choice.
And they're off. In the Iroquois. Towards the inside, Laddie Boy is ridden to try and get the early lead, followed through by Rise Up. A little bit wider is Jimmy Connors, and then Ride On Curlin and Tapisher towards the inside. There's a break back to Honorable Judge as they go around the clubhouse turn. Towards the inside is Cleburne, racing 3 wide, Solemnly Swear, and at the back of the field are Smart Cover and Stone Crusher through a 23-1 opening quarter mile. Heading down the back stretch, Laddie Boy aggressive to get the lead. Out in front by 3/4 of a length, Rise Up is racing in second. Still 3 deep out on the track is Ride On Curlin, who's racing just in third. Tapicha to the inside in fourth. Jimmy Connors is now in fifth with stablemate Solemnly Swear in sixth. They go through halfway in the 32nd running of the Iroquois, the half in 46-3, leaving the back stretch behind them, well strung out behind Laddie Boy and Jesus Castanon as they leave the back. Leads now by 1.5 lengths to in second place is Rise Up. Towards the outside, Ride On Curlin is in third. Tapiture is in fourth. 3 lengths away, Solemnly Swear. Then to the inside is Cleburne. Jimmy Connors is backing out of it, trying to pick up from the back Smart Cover and Stone Crusher. And tailed off is Honorable Judge as they come into the lane. On the outside, Ride On Curlin now gets the lead with Laddie Boy. Tapiture against the inside rail. These three as they race down towards the final furlong. Tapiture to the inside now takes the lead over Ride On Curlin in second. Down the outside, here comes Cleburne trying to spring the shock inside the 16th. Tapiture out in front with Cleburne and also Smart Cover up towards the line. Cleburne in the center. On the outside, Smart Cover, and on the inside, Tapiture. Cleburne in the center, and Corey Lannery may have just got the head bob in a 3-way go for the Iroquois.
Cleburne, might have taken 1.27 seconds slower than the girls to negotiate the mile and a 16th in the 32nd running of the Iroquois, but records the $102,000 winner share returning, get this, $70.20, ladies and gentlemen. And my notes, I know this race started in the early 80s, and my notes only go back to the early 90s, but this is by far the biggest mutual I have recorded for the Iroquois. And for Dale Romans and Donegal Racing, they follow it up with a 26-to-1 shot, Smart Cover, who runs second for a $500 on the button exacta. Tapiture, second choice in the wagering at 2-to-1, finishes third. And Ride On Curlin, second career start after winning by 7¾ lengths at 2-to-1, finishes fourth under Calvin Burrell. And continuing the stakes action on Saturday afternoon, time for the fillies and mares on the dirt, a mile and 16th. The Locust Grove handicap, Flashy American, 8-to-5.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the Locust Grove. A very level break to the inside, Amy's Deanie, in the center, Wine Princess, lit up by the first-time blinkers, and she is flashing early speed, and Wine Princess will have the lead around the clubhouse turn. To the inside, Amy's Deanie, having broken just a step slow, Awesome Flower hustled up now to take third, Flashy American on her inside in fourth, Molly Morgan, then on the inside, Sigur Raya, Ice Cream Silence, last but one, and twice the lady at the back of the field. 24 and 1 for the opening quarter mile, and now Amy's Deanie through on the inside gets the lead to Wine Princess racing in second, a length and a half away, Awesome Flower in third, Flashy American the Grey racing in fourth, Molly Morgan then on the outside of Sigur Raya as they go through halfway in the 30th running of the Locust Grove, and they're racing towards the final half mile. The leading duo are kicking away, Wine Princess around the outside of Amy's Deanie. These are still the first two and a half lengths away now to Awesome Flower, who is racing in third, Flashy American, Molly Morgan around the outside, Sigur Raya is next, still the last two, Ice Cream Silence and Twice the Lady, as they race now towards the final quarter mile. Wine Princess to the outside, Amy's Deanie is being driven now, Flashy American now begins to try and close as they race towards the final furlong and a half. Wine Princess goes for home, the lead is a length and a half over Flashy American in second, Amy's Deanie. Down the outside is Awesome Flower. They're racing to the 16th. Wine Princess, Flashy American. These two jaw. Flashy American on top. Flashy American to win the Locust Grove. It was Flashy American and Corey Lannery who seized the initiative late to beat Wine Princess in the Locust Grove.
Ken McPeak sends out the winner, who has been very, very sharp of late. 4-for-5 recently with a second place finish in 4 stakes races plus an allowance race in the last 5. Flashy American, the gray daughter of Flashy Bull, looked very, very confidently ridden by Corey Lannery. They score the 1¼ length victory, returning $5.20. Second in the wagering at 9-to-5, Wine Princess finishes second with Awesome Flower, third in Saturday's Locust Grove. And wrapping up the stakes action at Churchill Downs for this week's show, the ACAC Stakes, the 21st running, the 2-to-1 favorite, Tap Town.
They're in the gate. And they're off in the ACAC Handicap, a picture-perfect start. In the center, it's Right to Vote, who now springs out and takes the lead to Tap Town racing in second, and then to the inside, Brethren, together with Pants on Fire. It looks as though this is a very solid early gallop. A break and opening up to Good Morning Diva, who's racing to the inside of Sabercat, Mo Man, and looking cool at the back of the field. 22-3, the opening click, and the leader is Right to Vote as they go down the back stretch. Tap Town out wide in second. On the inside rail, Brethren followed then by Pants on Fire. A break now of 5 clear lengths to Good Morning Diva, who is racing in 5th position. Sabercat is in 6th, followed in 7th by Looking Cool, and Mo Man sees them all, the half in 45-1. As they went through halfway in the 21st running of the ACAC, the leader is Right to Vote with 3/8 a mile to go. Tap Town right there, breathing down his throat latch in second. Pants on Fire now being ridden for third. Back in fourth and losing ground rapidly now. His Brethren, who's dropped right back through the field, will soon be tailed off. Tap Town took the lead at the head of the lane. To the outside, Pants on Fire. Then to the inside, Right to Vote. A furlong to go in the Akak. Tap Town on the inside. Pants on Fire draws alongside. Goes on for Paco Lopez and racing up towards the line. The Akak goes to Pants on Fire. Tap Town in second. Good Morning Diva stayed on for third, and in fourth was Right to Vote.
Pants on Fire, ladies and gentlemen. Paco Lopez now 5-for-9 lifetime aboard this runner for Kelly Breen and the Halls. Second choice in the wagering sets a new stakes record in a very fast one-turn mile of 133.78. The favorite Tap Town finishes second with Good Morning Diva third in this year's ACAC handicap. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, Louisiana Downs, Del Mar, Saratoga, and Belmont.
I'm Seth Merrill. Join me weekdays at 9 a.m. for Racing Across America. We'll look at important races from across the country, get insights from top handicappers and analysts, and preview the upcoming week in racing. That's Racing Across America, weekdays at 9, here on OTB TV.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
I'm Jeff Carl. Join me Saturdays and Sundays at 10 for the Handicappers Report. We'll take a look at the top tracks across the country and help you prepare for the weekend in racing. That's the Handicappers Report, weekends at 10, only here on the OTB TV network.
Louisiana Downs, ladies and gentlemen, time for the 34th running of the Super Derby, a mile and an eighth for $500,000. Departing, coming off a brilliant, brilliant victory in the West Virginia Derby, the 3-10 choice.
In the gate. And they're off in the Super Derby. And Holiday Mischief with a great start down inside. On the outside, here comes Ruler of Love in cameo appearance, and Departing is up close too. Racing for the clubhouse turn, and Ruler of Love out to be the leader. Cameo Appearance is going to sit right there in the outside in second, and Holiday Mischief with a good spot down inside running in third. Treasury Bill's in behind while fourth, and Departing is in the clear in the outside running in fifth. A break of two back to Bashar. Bashar much closer to the pace today, only about six lengths off the lead and is on hold. And at the back, it's Runaway Steven. 23-3, they move for the back stretch run. Ruler of Love in front, one length to Cameo Appearance, who runs in second. Departing is in the clear still on the outside in third. Robbie Alvarado with a firm hold of that one, racing about 2.5 lengths off the lead. That is Treasury Bill and Holiday Mischief. Bashar continues to run much closer to the pace. He's only about 4 lengths behind, and he's going to follow Departing past the half-mile pole. A break of another 5 back to late running Runaway Steven. Ruler of Love onto the fire turn, got a half in 49 1/5 seconds. Ruler of Love cruising to the 3/8 pole. There goes Departing. Departing takes off on the outside, third, and now second. And coming after Ruler of Love, Cameo Appearance is back running in third. Farther back, Runaway Steven revving up on the far outside. And that is Treasury Bill, Holiday Mischief, and Bashar. They're off the turn. They're into the stretch of the Super Derby. And it is Departing to take over. Departing has taken over at the top of the stretch. But Ruler of Love is going to fight him by the eighth pole. No matter, though, Departing takes off again. Opens up to lead by 2. Departing now by 3. Departing in a dominating performance. He wins the Super Derby, and he scores by 4. Ruler of Love was second. Cameo Appearance was third, and it's tight for fourth. Treasury Bill or Runaway Steven.
Al Stahl sends out Departing with Robbie Alvarado aboard once again. They are now 2-for-2 aboard. Departing wins off by 4 lengths. Not quite as impressive as the nearly 9-length victory in the West Virginia. But Departing, who had a bump in the road in the Preakness Stakes, certainly seems to have found his sea legs at this level as he matures into a fine three-year-old runner. Ruler of Love finishes second. Cameo appearance under Patrick Valenzuela finishes third in this year's Super Derby. Bringing the curtain down at Del Mar, ladies and gentlemen, on Labor Day, we had the mile on the 16th. Hard to say that. Hard to say at Del Mar. Second time they've run it at Del Mar. This is the yellow ribbon. Last year's winner, Hello Dolly, the 9-to-5 choice.
The yellow ribbon. And away they go. A Jealous Woman takes up her customary role as the pacemaker. A Jealous Woman goes clear. The Grey Egg Drop getting up second. Quiet Oasis along the inside. They are followed by Halo Dolly in the fourth spot. Then back to Royal Empress in fifth. Customer Base is now seven off the leaders. Appealing is on the outside of that. Then My Gigi and Closing Range is at the back. They head to the three-quarter pole. A Jealous Woman along the inside and Egg Drop. They ensure a steady pace out here. They go clear to lead by just over two. Quiet Oasis is in the third spot. Halo Dolly, the perfect spot. Fourth, four lengths off the leader. Another two back to Royal Empress, who's pretty keen to go on. Up alongside comes Customer Base. They've been followed by Appealing, who's now eight off the leaders. Three more to My Gigi and Closing Range. They have a half mile left to go, and A Jealous Woman in front, a length and a half to Egg Drop. Quiet Oasis third, Halo Dolly fourth, four lengths off the leaders. Customer Base is on the far side. Between horses, Royal Empress appealing at the rail. Only four and a half off these leaders. Now they're bunching up. Behind that comes Closing Range and My Gigi. They are coming to the top of the lane. A Jealous Woman now under pressure, taken on by Egg Drop. Halo Dolly coming with a run. Appealing is in with a shot too. Appealing cuts the corner and comes after them. They are homeward bound and Egg Drop goes on. A Jealous Woman battles. Appealing has a shot on the inside. Appealing now coming gamely. Halo Dolly, My Gigi in the white cap. Here comes My Gigi flying late. Appealing, Egg Drop, My Gigi gonna hit it. Oh, Egg Drop. My Gigi did not get through. Egg Drop will win it. Egg Drop in a thriller. Egg Drop appealing. My Gigi did not get through. And Halo Dolly finished fourth.
Egg Drop with Martin Garcia, ladies and gentlemen, as second choice in the wagering. Scores the first career stakes victory, returning $8 even. Appealing finishes second as the by far longest shot on the board at better than 30-1. My Gigi finishes third with Hello Dolly, who previously was 4-for-5 lifetime at Del Mar, finishing fourth as the 9-to-5 favorite. And Wednesday afternoon, the finale, the traditional closing day feature, two-year-olds going 7 furlongs in the Grade 1 Del Mar Futurity, Albert's Hope, 7-to-2.
And away they go. On the far side, Indexical Bivan very quickly. Guns Loaded shows early speed as well. Now along the inside, Can the Man runs up alongside of the leaders. And Alpine Luck in the blue colors right there too. Guns Loaded, another one in there. Ooh, Can the Man just duck to the left pretty sharply there. Another one up with the leading group is Rum Point. Then we come back to Celtic Moon, six at the rail, only three lengths off the leaders though. California Chrome's in behind that, and then comes Dance with Fate in the pink colours. Tamarando's back third last. Albert's Hope is back second last, and last of all, Sky Dreaming, 10 off the lead. Into the turn they go now. On the far side, Indexical. Down at the rail, Can the Man. Indexical, Can the Man, lead it by two. Then comes Alpine Luck in third. Guns Loaded is fourth. Behind that, we have Rum Point now dropping out of it. On the far side, Albert's Hope. In behind that, Tamarando. They are coming to the top of the lane now, and Can the Man along the inside, and Indexical, Can the Man, Indexical, Guns Loaded coming after them, California Chrome running on, Tamarando's getting involved, Tamarando with a late run down the center of the track, wide open, Can the Man at the rail. Can the Man, now here comes Dance with Fate on the extreme outside. Can the Man is about 5-6 in a line. Tamarando, Tamarando's going to get up. Tamarando won a thrilling stretch run in the Futurity. Tamarando close for second. Dance with Fate, Can the Man.
Tamarando with the very, very late run for Julian Leperoux, taking on winners for the first time, scores by half a length in the Grade 1 Del Mar Futurity, returning $17.80 for trainer Jerry Hollendorfer and others. Dance with Fate finishes second. Canada Man finishes third, with Albert's Hope, previously undefeated, coming out of the victory, and the Best Pal finishes fourth as the favorite. And that wraps up Del Mar for 2013, and now time to wrap up Saratoga for 2013, going back to Labor Day. Two stakes races to bring you. Unfortunately, the first one washed off the turf, downgraded to a listed stakes, shortened up to a mile and an eighth on the muddy sealed racetrack. The 18th running of the Glens Falls Stakes, which really became a main track only event. And if you take Cash for Clunkers, who was in the main body, but if you look at her resume, you might have thought that off the turf was in for her. Lady Cohiba, 3-2.
And the rough. Lady Cohiba. And Greed and Fears right to her outside, to her inside, Cash for Clunkers. Just to their outside, now Malibu Holiday runs fourth as they move into the clubhouse turn. The gray-white rolls down toward the rail. Then in between horses, Scampering. Scampering now runs along in fifth. Kishigal sixth on the outside. And White Rose back to trailing as they round the clubhouse turn. Lady Cohiba, prompted by Greed and Fear through the opening quarter mile. That was up in 23 3/5 seconds. Solid pace established early on here by Lady Cohiba. Right in her hip pocket is Greed and Fear, running second by two. Then Malibu Holiday right there together with Cash for Clunkers. They're running third and fourth. Mike Smith has guided Gishigal to the clear on the outside, running along in fifth now. And then it's Scampering and White Rose, the trailer. Lady Cohiba through a half in 47 3/5 seconds. Greed and Fear has been glued to her the whole way as they approach the half-mile pole. Then down inside, it's Cash for Clumpers right next to her. Malibu Holiday runs along in fourth. And then farther back, Lady Geisha called on for run now, 5 lengths from the lead, followed by White Rose down toward the rail and Scampering. It is wide open here. There's only 5.5 lengths from front to back with 3 furlongs to go, 3/4 up in 12-1. Lady Cohiba trying to go it all the way on the lead. Here comes Gishigal revving up on the outside, second with 1/4 mile to go. White Rose last on the back stretch, third and closing at the rail at the top of the stretch. Then farther back, it's Scampering. There's 1 furlong to go. Lady Cohiba trying to hang in there. Still 1.5 lengths. White Rose comes off the inside. Lady Cohiba spurts away. White Rose second. And Gishigal third. And Scampering fourth. And they're coming down to the finish. And it will be Lady Cohiba holding on. Under the aggressive Junior Alvarado, they go wire to wire in the Glens Falls. White Rose was closing at the end, second on the line, followed by Scampering and Gishigal.
Christophe Clement, Junior Alvarado, they go to the front end, make every pole a winning one, returning $5 even. White Rose finishes second, with Scampering third in Labor Day's Glens Falls. Grade 1 action on closing day at Saratoga. 2-year-olds in the Hopeful Stakes. Corvo, 7-2.
And the rough. Strong mandate broke well. Corfu comes up from the inside. Wired Brian has some early speed. All in Blue is with the Vanguard as well. Then Long and Value down toward the inside. Lunar Warfare now moving from 7th. King Cyrus 8th on the far outside. They're followed by Big Sugar Soda. And the trailer is Southern Blessing. A tight pack through the opening quarter mile here. They are led by Corfu, who drilled that quarter in 22 2/5 seconds over the muddy going here. Wired Brian continues on in second. Strong mandate with the pacemakers on the outside. And then it's Long on Value down toward the rail, running along in fourth. All in Blue starting to hit his best stride. Now he's fifth on the outside, a break of three. Back to Casa Huapo, now running along in sixth. They're midway around the far turn. The half was up in a demanding 45 seconds flat. And here comes Strong mandate to the neck of Corfu. Those two will hit the quarter pole together as they turn for home here in the Hopeful. And then it's Long on Value, who's coming through an opening toward the inside. Wired Brian is now running fourth. Then toward the outside, All in Blue. And Casa Huapo on the far outside. Strong mandates come away with the lead. And he's pulling away. Pulling away with complete authority here. He will leave the others in his muddy wake. And Strong Mandate is geared down for the last 16th of a mile. Oh, this is a very promising 2-year-old. He won by about 7 or 8 lengths. Casa Huapo appeared to get second, close for third there. Lunar Warfare and Big Sugar Soda.
Strong mandate, ladies and gentlemen, who gave Wayne Lucas his first winner of the meet before he added the Traverse Stakes to the docket, now adds the 109th hopeful to his resume. This is the 7th hopeful stakes Wayne Lucas has won. Strong mandate wins by nearly 10 lengths, which I think is a new stakes record, ladies and gentlemen, eclipsing General Assembly. But at 7-1, a brilliant, brilliant performance by this runner, taking on winners for the first time, returning $16.60. Casioapo coming up from two efforts at Calder. Longest shot on the board, finishes a good second. Lunar Warfare also coming up from South Florida, but second start at Saratoga, finishes third. And Corvu, making the third start of the meet, beats one horse as a 7-2 favorite. That wrapped up Saratoga 2013 on Labor Day. Saturday afternoon was opening day at Belmont Park on the inner turf course, the Grade 2 Bowling Green at a mile and a quarter, boisterous 3-4.
And they're off. Boisterous, quick Casablanca, quick Casablanca. Showing some initiative here and going on to lead them as they move for the first turn. Farhan, a bit wide, moving into the turn, up to be second now, just a half length behind the front runner, Quick Casablanca. Then it's Boisterous, who's over down toward the hedge, saving ground into the turn. London Lane right alongside him. Two lengths back to Hyper, who is fifth in the early going, and Finnegan's Wake is the last of the six. He's about a half dozen lengths from the lead. The leader is Quick Casablanca as they make their way toward the backstretch run. London Lane up close but well held. Wide round the first turn, Farhan. Boisterous save ground all the way, and he is under a hammerlock in behind the leaders while saving ground. Right next to him, it's Hyper. Finnegan's Wake continues to trail the field, still about six from the lead. So they're three quarters of a mile out here. The opening half was 48 4/5 seconds. The leader remains Quick Casablanca. On the outside, Farhan edges up second. London Lane right up there, third with 5 furlongs remaining. Boisterous has an opportunity to get a foothold at the inside as they move into the far turn, and he's up there to be fourth. Hyper's right alongside him. Finnegan's Wake still about 6 from the lead, a half mile to go. Quick Casablanca has been providing the pace here. Ran 3/4 and 12-4. They're midway around the far turn. Quick Casablanca, a length. Farhan second. London Lane right there in between horses. There goes Hyper. Hyper revving up on the far outside. Boisterous remains at the rail. He's only 2 lengths from the lead now. And Finnegan's Wake comes alive just outside the quarter pole. Quick Casablanca the leader. Boisterous looking for a way through. Hyper's right there on the outside. And Finnegan's Wake is coming on now. They're into the final furlong. Hyper's come away with the lead. And Finnegan's Wake. Boisterous has to alter course to the outside in the final 8th. Down to the final 16th. Hyper. Finnegan's Wake lengthening that stride as the wire comes up quickly. It's Hyper trying to hang in there. And Hyper did. Hyper held on by a neck. Finnegan's Wake was second. Boisterous was third. Quick Casablanca was fourth.
Hyper, coming off of the stakes victory at Saratoga, now adds the Grade 2 Bowling Green to the resume under Javier Castellano for Chad Brown. They were second choice in the wagering. They returned $7.90. Finnegan's Wake finishes second. And Boisterous, as you saw them coming to the top of the stretch on the turn, John Velasquez was looking to get a golden trip along the hedge, but Luis Saez under Quick Casablanca set the trap and then pulled the trap, ladies and gentlemen, by just shutting off Boisterous, who then had no place to run on the outside and can do only third as the 3-4 favorite in the Bowling Green handicap. Well, that wraps up this week's edition of Horses and Courses, ladies and gentlemen, as we work our way into autumn, as it were. It's still officially summertime, and our eyes turn our attention to the one-stop prep races for the Breeders' Cup. We will have all of those stakes action on the next edition of Horses and Courses.